Alan Grice was second, and I would think that would make Peter Janson very, very happy indeed. Janson at the wheel for the final stint would be aware of his standing in the race and would not want to be doing anything ridiculous or any bravado needed to... there's nothing to prove. There's no way he can catch the race leader. He only has to sit there and conserve and make sure nothing goes wrong so he can lock up second place.
Second place outright, in second place in the class, and in fourth place in the index of performance, Peter Janson's Torana. 60 cars started, there are 29 left. Remaining.
Here he comes, the captain, Peter Janson, and the Cadbury Schweppes car. Torana. Peter has done a great job also in promoting the race through his press association with the Mirror and also Auto Action. A very colourful character. It's great to see people like Peter Janson, whose sponsors also back the sport very, very strongly. Okay, looking for a run-through, as we're giving you at the moment. Position 1, car 5, Peter Brock and Jim Richards. Position 2, car 19, the Janson-Perkins entry. Position 3, the Radburn-Smith entry. Good to see that too. Position 4 is the Grice Costanzo Torana. Position 5, the Gary Rogers-Kennedy Torana. In position number 6, we have the Taylor Kennedy Torana. Position number 7 is Bo Seaton. Good to see Bo Seaton up too, because we haven't seen a great deal of him in the telecast in the Unipart Torana, but running strongly. In 8th position, after looking certain for 2nd, was Charlie O'Brien and Garth Wigston in the Phillips entry. Position number 9, a favourite I think by this afternoon's effort, is Peter Williamson and Mike Quinn in the Toyota Celica. And in position number 10, just look at that, the small car, the Brian Foley Alfetta of McDonald, Phil McDonald and Derek Bell.
So it's Torana's 1-8 and two-litre cars in 9th and 10th positions. 2 laps to go for Peter Brock and for the race, and Brock just went round in 2.24. Hot on the pace, just as he was at the start of the race.
If the car is feeling good, I would think that Peter Brock, I might be wrong, but last year, if you recall, he tried to put a blinder in the final lap, just to prove that his car, his factory car, was running as sweetly at the completion of the race as it was in the opening lap.
Not only has he run him into the ground, he probably wants to show that he could do it again if he had to.
Yes. I think he'd be quite happy just the same to step from the car, probably have a cup of tea and retire to the presentation area. There he is over the top of the mountain, absolutely impeccable. Don't see Peter Brock putting any wheel over the white line into the dirt. He's watching through here. Spot on, over the top of the mountain. Overlapping the Volvo again. Listen to the crowd. They're already warming to the last lap. He has 1.5 laps to go. And staring his 4th Hardy Ferrodo Bathurst win in the face. Over the top. Now down to the wide open spaces of Breville Conrod Strait. One can only guess it's what is running through the mind of not only Peter Brock at this stage, of his team manager John Shepherd, who remains absolutely cool under all circumstances. Crews already starting to line the pit area to cheer on Peter Brock, to salute him. What else can you do? Every card that they have played has fitted. It's spot on. Here he comes, 05. It was the story in 1978. It is the same story in 1975. The one lap to go flag will come out. The signal has been given to Peter Brock. And there you can see on the right the crowd in the pit road signalling this great driver. Ranks probably as, well, right in there alongside Alan Moffat, as one of the great touring car drivers in Australia. The record is on the board, as they like to say, going up Avco Mountain Straight now for the final time. A That'll add to snapping concentration, because he still has three-quarters of a lap to complete. Here he comes.
Faultless performance by the Marlboro Holden dealer team, led by John Shepherd, and of course this car driven by Peter Brock and Jim Richards. Mop-headed at any stage of the event.
Just overlapping there, the 10th place car, the Donald Bell Alfetta, up to the cutting once again. And wait for the reaction of spectators, the thousands upon thousands of them up the top part of the circuit, who will be down near the fences. You'll be able to hear their cheers as Peter Brock, 05 for the Marlboro Holden dealer team, comes across the mountain, the man who has conquered the mountain three times and staring a fourth in the face. Here he comes. Listen to the applause, the accolades for a man among men when it comes to race car drivers. Still tidying. Picks up the inside rear wheel that time. Peter Brock is trying and trying hard in this last lap. It'll be known as not only the race which this car led every lap of the race, it'll be interesting to check his final lap time. We have a timer on him. Conrod straight away. There you can see Bathurst in the background. Peter Brock wants to see one thing and one thing only, the checkered flag. For his fourth, Bathurst. Hardy Fredo, 1,000 win. And here he comes, down Breville Conrod Strait for the final time. No traffic to worry him. He's in good shape. It's been a long race, a race that this car has led every lap of. Down into the braking area, back through the gears. Listen to the crowd warming up. A checkered flag unfolds a page in history as Peter Brock and the Marlboro Holden dealer team comes across to take the checkered flag for the Peter Brock. You'll probably find that his lap time will read somewhere in the 221
point something.
He's done it. What a season for this incredibly talented driver, the man who only a month ago went round Australia in the Repco reliability trial, led the 1-2-3 finish for Commodore. He's just picked up another Hardy Ferrado Classic, another 1,000 kilometre sprint. He made it look like a Sunday afternoon drive. All around the circuit are the cars that didn't make it, the ones who dropped out in the second and the third and the fourth, the 80th, the 121st lap. Peter Brock's car just kept on running. The checkered flag is out to signal the completion of the race. The cars will return to the pit area. Peter Brock would be elated. John Shepherd now believes it has happened. They have won the Hardy Ferrado once again. And what a combination, if looking for the Grand Slam for this season. He missed the Australian Touring Car title by a very narrow margin to Bobby Morris. He won, of course, the Hang 10 400.